Hi, I'm Cassandra Gartung, and I'm an on-site instructional coordinator at Irwin Academy of the Performing Arts and the Victor Elementary School District. In today's lesson, we did a three acts math lesson. The three acts math lesson goes into three different acts, such as you would follow in a movie. I want to make sure that you guys understand our learning goal today. Our learning goal today is to be able to understand how math can apply to your everyday life, how we can use math in the real world. Okay, I want you to be able to make sense of the problem I give you and be able to work through it. Okay, I want you to have the growth mindset. The first act we started with is an information seeking stage. So what I did is I posed a problem by showing the students a video. Then I also want you guys to come up with question statements. We call them wonder, okay? So what are you thinking in your mind? What are you wondering? What kind of questions can you think of? And for this case, I want you to think of math questions. What kind of math questions could we pose coming from this video? Okay, I'm gonna give you about another 2 minutes to keep writing. So go ahead and keep writing. What did you notice? And what do you wonder? Now we're gonna do think, pair, share, okay? So I'm gonna have you guys collaborate with your shoulder partners, okay?
What will happen to the rope?
Why is the person tying a knot?
Why is he tying the knot?
In the notice statements, I make sure to clarify any ideas that the students actually see from the video, because everybody has a different perception of what they might see and interpret. So you really need to hone in on what your students are thinking and clarify ideas.
I noticed three knots in the rope.
Oh, you noticed three knots.
Right. Yes, you.
I noticed that the rope got smaller the more the person makes knots.
Okay, the rope got smaller. What do you mean by smaller?
The more you made knots, the less rope there was.
Did he take away any of the rope?
No, but he did make the rope smaller by making the knots.
So the knots were doing what to the rope? So they were taking up some of the rope? Okay.
Okay, go ahead.
How many knots does it take to fill in the rope?
Okay, so your question is, how many knots will it take to what?
To
fill in the rope. To fill in the rope. Okay, so that's an excellent question. So now we're going to move on, and I really love that math question there, okay? I like your question about how many knots will it take to fill in the rope, because we see he makes one knot, he makes another knot, and he's starting on the third knot, right, when we pause the video. So do you think he's going to continue?
Yeah.
You guys think he's going to continue? From there, we start to form an investigation. What are we actually looking for? We were able to discover our main question. I would like everybody in box number 3 to write our main question, and I'm gonna put a star by it. How many knots will it take to fill in the rope? Then we go to the estimation number line. First and foremost, it's really important that the estimate on a number line, because the number line is mentioned within the Common Core State Standards repeatedly. And so that needs to be an accessible thing that they're doing every single day. And this is really important because this gets the students starting to think about what could be a possible solution to the answer, as well as it gives me a formative assessment of where the students' thinking is at this point in the lesson. So we decided collectively as a group what would be a low estimate and then what would be the highest estimate. And then I wanted to get their own estimation. From there we go to Act 2, which is known as the conflict or the productive struggle stage. And this is where they start to problem solve. Before they start to problem solve, they have to make sure to ask me the correct questions to get more information about the act, because I have not revealed any mathematical statements or processes as of yet. So Act 2 is, are we ready to solve? And what information do you need? Okay, so I would like you to once again talk with your shoulder partner and think about any information that you might want from me. okay, that I can give you to solve our problem of how many knots will fill in the rope.
And once they pose the correct questions, I'm able to give them some more information that they can then go and tackle the problem with.
Okay. Now that you have had a chance to discuss this about what kind of more information do we need, because I know I haven't supplied you with a lot of information to this point, and neither has the video, I'm going to go to our wonder statements first, because somebody asked a great question earlier, so I'm going to go straight to here and see if this solves maybe those needed information, okay? And somebody asked up here, how long is the rope? How many of you guys had the same question? How many were wondering, how long is this rope? Okay, you have a question.
How big are the knots?
How big are the knots? Did everybody hear that?
Yeah. So then I give them time to go through and solve the problem. And I start going around the room and making observations at this point. And so I look for students who are either struggling or students who are excelling at this point. I ask for partners of my struggling students to give them assistance so that they can clarify ideas that they may have any misconceptions about. Also at this point, I start to look for possible solutions to be presented to the class. And I look for a variety of ways. I look for students that can give me different standards of the mathematical practice and that are relevant to the smarter balance claims. So I'm starting to look for different ways they modeled the math, different strategies that they used to do the math. I also look for, was it a struggling student who was able to persevere through it and actually arrive at the same correct answer after fixing those mistakes?
Excellent. Okay, excellent. Can you write your answer statement and then explain right here for me?
And then we go to Act 3, which is the resolution stage. And if you notice during the resolution stage, I don't like to give them the answer right away.
So I went around the room and I saw an interesting math strategy you used, or I saw an interesting pattern you might have used, I just did a little star on your paper, and I'm going to have you come up now, and you're going to teach the class your answer or your math process.
So I looked at how long the rope was, and it was 44 inches, and each knot was 4 inches. So I did 44 divided by 4, which is 11. And then I did 11 times 4. Then it was 44. Then I counted by 4s until I got to 44, and I counted them all, and it was 11.
Okay. So yours up high, because you got a good pictorial.
I used tally balls. Marks to solve the answer, because I used tally marks so I could count to 4, and I counted all the way to 44, and my answer was 11.
I got my answer by doing 44 divided by 4, because I knew that it was 44. That the rope was 44 inches in all, and without the knots, and then with the knot, I noticed that each knot was took away 4 inches, so I did 44 divided by 4, and I got 11.
And then finally, we show them the answer, and we actually show the answer in the video.
I don't know. You guys want to see it?
Yes.
Are you dying to see it?
Yes.
Okay, here we go.
So I don't just give them the number and move on. They actually see the video in which, in the real world context of him tying the knots until the knots are completed in the rope. These tasks are really engaging to students. If you notice, the students at all times were in the math and were enjoying this process. And they were so excited at the end to hear the answer as they jumped up in the air. And you will see this time after time, that the students are enjoying this real world math application as opposed to another math worksheet that might be done in class. At the beginning and the end of the lesson, I made sure to clarify the ideas as part of the formative assessment process. I wanted to make sure the students understood what our success criteria was for the day and our learning goals were for the day. So as I was walking around the room making observations, I was putting red stars on papers. And this was because I was seeing a variety of different strategies that students were able to solve the math problem. In particular, if we noticed, there was student number 5 who solved the problem using tally marks. His way was very unique to any individual in the classroom, because as I was observing and doing the formative assessment process, no other student in the classroom had that same model. And I thought that was a very important feature that the students could see that there was a different way than what they had on their paper. But at the same time, I made sure to select other strategies that students could relate to as well, because they might be able to see a strategy from another student that was presented. So some students went straight to the algorithm, some students did repeated addition, and some students did repeated subtraction. And so there was such a variety that all the students should be able to relate to one of the solutions presented. I believe it was really important for the students to have time in the think, pair, share process to communicate their ideas between each other. And it helps them to see another person's perspective, as well as maybe get new ideas and get a fresh way of thinking. So it was very important that throughout the process that they had that time for discussion and talk and sharing of ideas. And were we able to solve it using multiplication?
Yes.
Division?
Yes.
Repeated addition?
Yes.
Repeated subtraction?
Yes.
And modeling? Because we had tally marks? Okay, excellent. At the end of the lesson, in order to act on evidence, I want to be able to see which students maybe had any misconceptions, pull them into a small group, and clarify any misunderstandings they might have had. And then I can also go and take the lesson and extend the lesson further into a second day and possibly explore some of the other wonderings that my students might have had. This task can be used in any classroom, in any grade level, and in any subject matter with great results.